ग्रेड 8 बायोलॉजी ग्रुप प्रिडिक्शन एंड मैनेजमेंट मॉड्यूल 3 ऑब्जेक्टिव्स इन दिस मॉड्यूल यू विल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब मैन्यूर एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स एक्सप्लेन इरिगेशन एंड मेथड्स ऑफ इरिगेशन मैन्यूर एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स द सब्सटेंसेस व्हिच आर एडेड टू द सोइल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स फॉर द हेल्थी ग्रोथ ऑफ प्लांट्स आर कॉल्ड मैन्यूर एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स व्हाट इज मैन्यूर मैन्यूर इज एन इनऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंस that increases soil fertility. It is prepared from decomposition of animal excreta and plant waste. It consists of organic matter and nutrients essential for the plant. It improves the soil structure by increasing its water holding capacity and also avoids water logging. Preparation of manure. Plant and animal waste are dumped in pits at open places and allow it to decompose by microbes. The decomposition product is manure. Advantages of using manure. It enhances the water holding capacity of the soil. It makes the soil porous, due to which the exchange of gases become easy. It increases the number of useful microbes in the soil. And it improves the texture of the soil. Fertilizer. Fertilizers are chemical substances which are rich in a particular nutrient. Example, urea, ammonium sulfate, superphosphate, potash and NPK. Disadvantages of fertilizer. There are a few disadvantages associated with use of fertilizers. Cause water pollution if followed by excessive irrigation. Excessive use can spoil soil fertility. Differences between fertilizer and manure. A fertilizer is an inorganic salt. Manure is a natural substance obtained by the decomposition of cattle dung, human waste and plant residues. A fertilizer is prepared in factories. Manure can be prepared in the fields. A fertilizer doesn't provide any humus to the soil. Manure provides a lot of humus to the soil. Fertilizers are very rich in plant nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Manure is relatively less rich in plant nutrients. Irrigation. Irrigation is supply of water to the crops in regular time intervals. Time and repetition of irrigation varies from crop to crop, from different soil types as well as from season to season. For example, during summers, evaporation from plant body and soil is higher, due to which irrigation is done frequently. Sources of irrigation. There are various sources, wells, ponds, lakes, canals, tube wells and dams. Methods of irrigation. There are two methods, traditional method and modern method. Traditional methods. Mod, chain pump, wet lift, rahat are some of the methods which brings water out of well, lakes, canals for irrigation. These methods are based on animal or human labor, therefore are cheap and less efficient. Pumps are the most common among the traditional methods. Modern methods. These methods are more economical and as compared to traditional methods. Sprinkler system. In this system, vertical pipes are provided with rotating nozzle on top and is joined to main pipeline at regular intervals. With the help of pump, water is allowed to pass through the pipes with high pressure. Pressure allows the nozzle to rotate and water is sprinkled on the crop, similar to rain. It is useful in case if the ground is not leveled or in case of sandy soil. Drip system. In this method, irrigation is done drop by drop near the plants, so that only part of the soil near the roots are wet. This type of irrigation is done for fruit, plants, garden and trees. Moreover, drip irrigation there is no wastage of water. However, irrigation needs to be done more frequently.